Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. Today we are going to talk about the difference between the 2J NA and the GTE oil pump. This episode is important especially when you want to choose which oil pump you are going to use for your 2JZ engine. Some of the terminology of the oil pump. The oil pump is driven by the crankshaft. That's why the harmonic balancer is very important because it can absorb the vibrations so it will not crack your oil pump. Remember guys to check my other video about the 2JZ main pulley. The oil pressure is generated about 10 psi per 1000 rpm. That is why if you guys tune up your engines to achieve very high revolutions, more than 8000 RPM, it may peak up to 65 or 80 PSI onwards. Therefore, there is a relief valve can prevent the oil pressure from going too high. The reason of not going too high oil pressure is the oil pump seal or the flywheel oil seal may leak due to high oil pressure. I'm going to show to you guys what is the difference between a 2J NA oil pump and a 2J GTE oil pump. Alright, so we always heard that the oil pump for the GTE provides more oil pressure. So when you go for NA, convert to turbo, especially you are using the block, the oil pump needs to be replaced. So I bought 5 engine block, NA block, and then I also got 1 GTE oil pump. So I opened one of the NA oil pump and try to compare and see whether you guys are convinced or not these two are different. So visually see these two, it's really not much of a difference. So the diameter of the inlet and outlet are the same, alright, but when you open up the cover, and then the cover cannot be replaced also, cover here cannot be replaced, alright, and the most important thing actually, let's see slowly one by one, okay, we can see here there's a recess here, so that the oil can flow through and lubricate this surface. Okay, over here, there's only a little bit. Okay, so it will maintain high pressure. Okay, and also when you open this, the center one, it is clearly bigger. Okay, it's clearly bigger than the NA one. And you can see from here. Alright, you see, it is so much bigger, and then the number of teeth is the same, but definitely the housing is smaller. Alright, okay, the housing for this is so much smaller. Alright, you can see from behind. So much bigger, okay, and then further than that I've also noticed that over here it is quite deep cut into it, and then here there are two shallow parting lines go through. Okay, over here is almost the same, but this one is slightly deeper, slightly narrower also. Here is bigger all the way. Alright, so many people, they try to increase the oil pressure by increasing the torque of this bolt here, or increase another spring, but which is not recommended. Okay, you can there are many ways to increase the oil pressure, but normally we don't do that, Okay, unless your tolerance for the main bearings and coil bearings are very, very loose.
Some engine tuners use looser tolerance for high boost, high RPM applications.
Okay, because we are using NA block, the NA block does not have oil squeezers, so the oil pressure are still very high. Okay, and if we compare these two, we can know what kind of things that we can improve the oil flow.
Okay, so what can we do to increase the oil pressure?
We can either use a higher viscosity of oil, which is we may introduce more wear to your bearings, which is not a really good solution. If you guys can see, this one is a bigger hole, this one is a smaller hole. So we can know that the bigger hole is the inlet, the oil coming in from here. Okay, so when it comes out, it flows out from here. But because of the manufacturing method, it's one big drill this hole, and then there is another big drill this direction. So that's why it will comes like this. But the oil flow is almost 90 degrees. So it will somewhat restrict the oil flow. So if you want to increase your oil flow and your oil pressure, grind it bigger and smoother, not 90 degree flow.
Two JZ oil pump does not need any oil restrictor compared with other engines such as SR20 or RB2526. The conclusion is, don't modify the NA oil pump, it's just waste of time. No need to change the spring, no need to modify the inlet outlet. Just change to a GTE new oil pump. That will solve all your problems.
Okay guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos, and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you!